I bet you have all entered a math lesson. And just after a few minutes into the explanation, your mind enters into a blank stage. And the same question invades you. Why am I learning this? This question summarizes the mentality of many students towards school, and especially towards subjects such as math. Because we tend to believe in stereotypes, where math is only a series of theorems that are printed in a book and seem useless in your daily life. This becomes more true as we grow up and learn more and more complex concepts that become more difficult or irrelevant each time. I remember a specific lesson of probability when I entered to the class, looked around, and everyone stared at the whiteboard, seeming to understand. But in the end, no one knew exactly why all these permutations and combinations would be useful. I remember I had to determine the number of ways different books could be arranged on a shelf. And it was quite complicated because of the different elements that needed to be taken into account. How the books were structured, if they could be turned around, if their position could be changed, if they could be flipped. And in the end, in front of me, a piece of paper full of combinations and the same question in my mind. Why am I learning this? However, as Dr. Julia Matto once said, focus on the process and not the outcome, and you will enjoy great success. Initially, this situation of finding the possibilities of arranging books would seem pointless. But the process of finding the different elements to get to the correct answer made this knowledge completely worthy. I also now understand that not every single concept I learned in school will be applicable in my life. As in this case, I won't go to a library, look up to a shelf, and find the different possibilities of the books, how the books would be arranged. But I am sure this problem enhanced my agility and my problem-solving skills. And I'm also sure that this is what a typical math teacher would tell you. But believe me, it is true. And if you don't believe me, according to a study performed by the Faculty of Medicine of Stanford University in 2015, each time you practice math, your brain develops neural pathways for processing information. And some parts of it gain a greater gray matter volume. Or in other words, you become more intelligent. Basically, you're able to improve your logical reasoning, as math in general gives you the necessary abilities to complete any kind of task. From the simplicity of splitting a bill, knowing how many hours you will sleep, playing music, setting your exercise routine, exchanging currency, driving, to the complexity of constructing a bridge, finding the correct way to land on the moon, or even determining the age of the universe. But these are just a few. This is what it really looks like. And still, we could include millions and millions of more applications. But what I want you to get out of this talk is that math is everywhere. Math has helped humanity develop the world we live in today, reaching far in architecture, in technology, in business, and basically in whatever you can imagine. Therefore, if you want to make part of this development, you must change your mindset. But this is a process because students have constructed a barrier of fear, where we believe math is static and the theorems cannot be altered. But we alter them every single day, and the most interesting part is that we do it completely unconsciously. What if I tell you that 7 + 8 = 3? The first thing that comes to your mind is, first of all, this is not true, and second, you're crazy. But now what happens if you look at your watch? If you wake up at 7 in the morning and 8 hours pass, it will be 3 in the afternoon. And this concept called modular arithmetic, which consists of doing operations within a closed system of repeating numbers, which in the case of a clock is 12 digits, is used by many other entities such as banks, who can determine your IBAN number, or basically the number of your account, from modular arithmetic algorithm. So for example, if your account has 10 digits and you forgot your last number, they can easily find it for you using the same concept you use every single day when you look at your watch. As another example, math is present in the life of many Colombians every single day. Have you ever asked yourself, how many possibilities are there of winning the lottery? This was something I had asked myself for many years, and it was only after a few lessons into the unit of probability I was able to find the answer. And in Colombia, there are more than 15 million possibilities for you to win the lottery. And if you want to picture that, that is approximately 0.00000006%. So imagine you represent this red dot in the diagram. This is you in 10 people, in 100 people, in 1,000 people, in 10,000 people. But it would have to put 1,500 equal slides, one beside the other, to represent your odds. And you, this tiny little red dot, this insignificant dot, would mean that the person winning the lottery is first, extremely lucky, and second, it is completely or almost impossible for you to win it. And this sort of concepts can shape your decisions every day. And I hope this helps you determine if you can buy or not the lottery ticket next time. What I really want to emphasize is that the concept on a textbook is completely useless. What makes it useful is to determine the applications this has on your life. And that is basically the problem. Because here I want to make a parenthesis and give my personal opinion, as I believe every math school system should not be centered on explaining a concept, but should also be centered on explaining how it can be applied, as it would certainly increase the interest. This will certainly increase the participation and further develop the minds of students. Because if you don't learn a concept with these applications, how do you expect someone will know how to apply it? And slowly, you begin to notice that learning math and changing your mindset towards it can help you with other subjects, with physics, with business, with economics, and even with art. Because using simple concepts such as golden ratio, you're able to construct a human body with exact proportions. So after all, next time you study math, next time you see this type of equations, this useless type of equations, I don't want you to see it as an obligation, but rather as an opportunity to understand the road to logic. Even when learning simple equations or far more complex concepts, think about things that you're not learning it for no reason. You're learning it for yourself, to form your intellect in whatever you want to be successful in. The final concept I want to emphasize on is that the important part is not the concept. The important part are the abilities learned, acquired by this concept. So next time you use math, you study math, you see your children struggling with math, what look will you give to it? Will you be part of the change? Thank you.